So what we've got is a mistake on the bass track of this song, and it's recorded to tape. And one of the questions we get asked the most when recording to tape is, what happens if we make a mistake? You're right, it's not the same as in digital world. We can't just go edit undo and record it again, but we can punch in just like you would digitally. The only thing is, we've only really got one chance to do it. Otherwise, next time we punch in, we're gonna have to keep punching into ever expanding sections of the song, and you may as well end up recording half the song again. So what we're gonna do today is locate precisely on the tape where the erroneous note is. Not only are we gonna mark it on the tape, we're gonna make a note of the time on the tape where it is, so that we can get the punch in exactly right. And we're simply gonna just record over the bum note with a fresh new one, which is exactly right, because you're gonna get it right this time, aren't you, Chris?
Good use of the word erroneous.
Letter of day is E. Yep, and that first letter in word.
Erroneous, yes. Yeah. So let's find exactly where the mistake is. It was 40 something, wasn't it? Okay, so it's about 45.
Okay.
What we're going to do is we're going to mark that on the tape using a white China marker, and we'll know precisely where it is. So we could, if we wanted, do a spot erase and erase that from the tape first, but as we're just going to punch in, we don't need to do that. So you should be able to just see there the white mark coming across the playhead. That's where the erroneous note is. So we've got it marked on the tape. So we're looking at precisely 6:45.
So you might be wondering why we mark the tape when there's a counter on the tape machine. The simple explanation for that is, if we for some reason have to do a cut and splice, or if we have to take the reel off the machine and take the spool off the machine and put it back on again, the counter will bear absolutely no resemblance to where it was before. So if we just mark the note on the tape, then we'll always know where the error was, and we can find it again easily. So what we do now is, once we've marked the error on the tape, we also make a note of the section where the error is, and the best punch, we'll find the best punch in point, and because it may be a few bars before. So once we're ready to go and we've got the bass set up and he's ready to re-record this section, what we'll do is arm the bass track on the tape machine and we'll play the tape. So we're gonna punch him in, we'll play the tape a little bit before the punch in point, so he can start playing along and it's not recording. And then once it gets to 6:41, I'm gonna hit record, I'll punch him in. And then once we get to 6:51, I'm going to hit stop, and that's going to punch him out, and we'll have just re-recorded the bars over that section, and hopefully we'll have got rid of that bum note.
The track's going to play. You can start playing whenever you want. Doesn't matter. I'm just going to punch you in at that right point. Cool?
Yeah.
So let's listen back. Just playing the track.
Lay back.
So as you can hear there, with the rest of the band, you literally can't tell the drop in. It's like it seamlessly goes across those sections. But for the purposes of showing you how to punch in, and that you can correct an error if you're recording to tape, you've made a mistake, it doesn't mean that you have to throw the whole thing away and start again from scratch. Like, you can literally just go back in and change like one note, which is what we've pretty much done there. I think that's about it.
Until next time.